Hi everyone, myself Dr Paidi Raghavulu, Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. Now I am going to explain today transportation model. Transportation model is a model which is used to optimize the transportation cost. The model, this particular transportation problem deals with the introduction to the transportation, finding an initial basic feasible solution by using northwest corner rule, lowest cost method, Vogel suppression method. These three methods are used to find initial basic feasible solution. After finding initial basic feasible solution, we will find the optimal solution by using the MODI method. MODI method means modified distribution method. Then we will discuss the special issues in modeling, that is unbalanced transportation problem, degeneracy transportation problem, and a maximization type of transportation problem. The general mathematical model of transportation problem is as shown in the display. We will have the sources S1 to SM and destinations D1 to DN. For each source to destination, there will be a transportation cost that is shown by Cij. Suppose we take the cell, this particular cell, this is a C11. Transportation cost from source 1 to destination 1. This is source 1 to destination 2. Like this it will go for all the cells, and for each source there will be a supply position, that is A1, A2, AM. Similarly, for each column there is a warehouse requirement or demand, that is B1, B2, it goes to up to BN. Total sum of supply and sum of demand should be equal. Like transportation problem, this also will have the set of constraints and objective functions. That there are m sources of supply and S1 to SM having AI is equal to 1 to M units of supply. Similarly, there will be a capacities D1, D2, DN with BJ, J is equal to 1 to 3 to N. CJ be the cost of shipping 1 unit of commodity from source I to destination J. The problem is to determine the transportation schedule so as to minimize the total cost of transportation. Here Xij is the quantity transported from source I to destination J. Mathematically, this problem can be stated as follows. Minimize the total cost, Z is equal to sum over Cij, Xij. This becomes objective function. Considering the availability quantity, sigma of Xij is equal to Aj for J 1 to M. Similarly, Xij is equal to Bj for J 1 to N. It is assumed that the total availabilities, that means supplies, equal to the requirements, demand. Finally, to execute this particular transportation model, we should have the three things. That is, we should have the cost matrix and factory capacity and warehouse requirements for all the warehouses, factory capacity for all the factories. The step-by-step procedure to solve the transportation problem. Step 1. Understand the given problem and formulate in the standard form. Step 2. Check the quality of Step 2. Check the equality of the total supply and demand. Step 3. Establish the initial basic feasible solution by using any of the following method. Method 1, the northwest corner rule. Method 2, least cost method. Method 3, Vogel suppression method. After finding the initial basic feasible solution by using any one of these methods, we'll optimize the solution by using the MODI method. For having clarity on the working of the problem, we will take a problem. A product is produced in three different factories, namely factory D, factory E, factory F. The product is shipped to the warehouses, namely warehouse A, warehouse B, warehouse C, in different cities in railroad. Each factory is able to supply the following number of units. Factory D, 100 units, factory E, 300 units, and factory F, 300 units. The distribution warehouses request the following units. Warehouse A, 300 units, warehouse B, 200 units. and whereas 200 units. This problem covers the all the requirements of the transportation problem. That is, we have the factory-based capacities and as warehouse-wise requirements, and also cost matrix we have. We can go ahead with the solving the problem. Now let us discuss in detail how to find the initial basic feasible solution for given problem. The problem can be shown pictorially as shown in the table. The problem is described pictorially as shown in the slide. This problem has three warehouses, three factories. All bluish are warehouses, all the red ones are factories, with the capacities of the requirements as shown nearby. The problem can be represented in the form of a standard transportation table form. Now here, the unit cost of transportation we have shown in the corner of the cell. This is 5 rupees. From factory D to factory A, warehouse A, from factory D to warehouse A, the cost is 5. Similarly, from D to B, 4 rupees. For D to C, 3 rupees. E to A, 8 rupees. E to B, 4 rupees. E to C is 3 rupees. Factory C to warehouse A, 9 rupees. Like this it goes. And here we represented the factory capacities. Factory D capacity is 100. Factory E capacity is 300. Factory C capacity is 300. Similarly, warehouse requirement is warehouse A, 300, 200, 700, 200. Warehouse C is 200. The total sum of the warehouse requirement becomes 700. This factory capacity also said to be 700. This, the both are equal. The problem is said to be balanced problem. That means the problem is the transportation problem is said to be balanced one. The both warehouse requirement and factory capacity are equal. The problem is said to be balanced transportation problem. Now we'll go in detail how to find the initial basic feasible solution by using the northwest corner rule. In this northwest corner rule method, the step is like this: understand the given problem and formulate a standard problem, and check the equality of the total supply and demand. That means factory capacity with the warehouse requirements. Now we'll go in detail how to calculate the initial basic feasible solution by using northwest corner rule. In this, what we'll follow is select the northwest corner cell, that means upper left hand corner cell, and allocate the maximum possible quantity of supply and demand. That means suppose supply is 300 per cell, demand is 200. At the maximum, how much you can supply, the minimum these two can supply. This will be explained now. I will explain once again the northwest corner rule in detail. The transportation problem shows the cost matrix, and factory capacities are shown, warehouse requirements are shown, and the factory capacity is 700, warehouse requirements also 700. The problem is said to be balanced. After seeing this, in this method, you have to select the cell for allotment of quantity, northwest corner cell. North is this side, west is this side. That means you have to top leftmost cell you have to take. Now you have to take this. At this point, how much you can assign? Now I will explain how to find the initial basic feasible solution using the northwest corner rule method. In this, the cell to be selected for allocation is north west corner cell. That is, this is north side, this is west, this is what the cell, that is DA cell we have to take. How much you can assign here? We can assign the minimum quantity of capacity, factory capacity oblique 300. That means you can assign here the minimum of hundred and 300. How much 100, 300? That becomes 100 only. Now with this assignment, this factory capacity requirements exhaust. Now we have to correct it accordingly. Now the warehouse requirement becomes, instead of 300 becomes 100 less, 200. Now we are left with 1, 2, 3, 6 cells. In this also you select the northwest cell, that is EA. How much incarnation here as per the earlier rule? Minimum of 300, 200. That is 300, 200 minimum. That will be incarnation here. 200. Now with this, this column get satisfied. This row reduces to 100. And you are left with only 4 cells. In the out of this, what is northwest? This is a cell to be EB. How much you can assign here? The minimum of 200 and 100. How much? 100. This cancels. Now you are left with how much? 100. Now we are left with only 2 cells. Northwest cell is this 7, this cell. How much you can assign? Minimum 100, 300. That is, you can assign 100. This cell vertical column get cancels. You are left with 200. Cell with only one cell with its capacity is 200. Its requirement is 200. That means the minimum of 200, 200 is 200. Now, what you have allocated, those cells are the occupied cells. For factory D, to warehouse A, you have to dispatch how many 100 numbers. And factory E to warehouse A, you have to dispatch 200 numbers. Factory E to warehouse B, you have to dispatch 100 numbers. From factory F to warehouse B, you have to send 100 numbers. Factory F to warehouse C, 200 numbers. The total comes to 700. That means you have allocated all of, we have utilized all the factory capacity as well as warehouse requirements. If you want to know the, what is the cost of this is 100 into 5 plus 200 into 8 plus 100 into 4 plus 100 into 7 plus 200 into 5. This I have shown separately the solution table. This is our solution table. 100 numbers, 200 numbers, 100. 100, 200, you use horizontal total 100, 100, to allocation 200 plus 100, 300 satisfies. The third row is 100 plus 200, 300 satisfies. So vertically also 100, 200, 300 get satisfied, 100, 100, 200 get satisfied. Now you have to write the initial basic visible solution table, you have to write. Along with this, you have to write the statement also. Transport from factory D to warehouse A, 100 units. Transport from factory E to warehouse A, 200 units. Transport from factory D, E to warehouse B, 100 units. Transport from factory F to warehouse B, 100 units. Transport from factory F to warehouse C, 200 units. And we have to do the, find the total cost. Total cost is equal to, as just I have told, 100 into 5 plus 200 into 8, 100 into 4 plus 100 into 7, 200 into 5. It is coming 4,200 rupees. Now we have to see one thing. Number of required cells is equal to M plus N minus 1. M is equal to number of rows of the cost matrix. N is equal to number of columns of the cost matrix. This is what the optimum solution. We have explained like this, the solution in the descriptive way. Transport from factory D to warehouse A, 100 units. Transport from factory E to warehouse A, 200 units. Transport from factory E to warehouse B, 100 units. Transport from factory F to warehouse B, 100 units. Transport from factory F to warehouse C, 200 units. The total cost of transportation is 100 into 5, 200 into 8, 100 into 4, 100 into 7, 200 into 5. It comes to 4,200. Now here you have to see, what is the number of required occupied cells. That is equal to M plus N minus 1. M is equal to number of rows of the cost matrix. N is equal to number of columns of the cost matrix. 3 plus 3 minus 1, 5. How many we got? Actually, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This, so number of occupied cells is equal to 5. Number of required cells is equal to 5. Both are equal. Since both are equal, the problem is said to be non-degenerate. You can go for optimization. If it is less, we have to make it equal by taking a any lowest cost cell as the occupied cell with its keeping an epsilon value, and you have to proceed. When it comes, I will explain in detail how to solve the non-degenerate problems. With this, I am sure that you can and appreciate the usefulness of the northwest corner rule to find the initial basic feasible solution. Now the summarizing table is what I have told just now, that as we have put in the sum of table, cost is coming out 4,200. This is self-explanatory. From factory D to warehouse A, 100 units at the cost of 5 rupees, total cost is 500. Transferred from E to A, 200 units, 8 rupees, 1600. From E to V, 100 units, 4 rupees, 400 rupees. From F to B, 100 units, 7 rupees each, 700. From factory F to C, 200 units at the rate of 5 rupees each, is coming 1000. All put together, 4200. Now, this is not the optimal solution. This is only one of the initial basic feasible solution. We will study next class the least cost method. Then we will appreciate which method is most optimal. From that method, we will use that method and find initial basic feasible solution. By working out all the methods, we will see which method is least cost, which method is the lowest, that method we will take up. We will proceed further to find the optimal solution in subsequent classes. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.